weird.
What's up?
I don't normally do these videos when he's sitting right there. Normally he's at work, so this is a little weird. I know this video is late. I'm sorry, it's my bad. I need to, as I mentioned on my Twitter post, I was in the States over the weekend and I wasn't able to film anything and have it edited by Sunday. So unfortunately no video came up that day, but I did promise that I would film in the week. So that is today, and I am pretty excited to do this look. I saw this video by Jamie Genevieve. She's like the best. She posted a video where she was talking about the new Make Me campaign by Cult Beauty, and basically what she did is she went from super glam face to a super natural face, and I thought that I should try it as well, because I mean, while I'm not like sponsored or anything to say this, I thought it would be pretty cool, you know, like why not. And if you're interested in participating in the campaign as well, it's you basically post a picture on Instagram using the hashtag MakeMe, and basically it's you're doing a look that is out of, that you've never really done before, you don't normally do, it's kind of a bit out of your comfort zone. So I'm gonna do that. I normally, if you've watched my videos on this channel, I normally do more a more lighter coverage foundation, not very glam, like kind of some bold eyes, but that's about it. That's the only bold thing. This video, I'm gonna go super bold, okay? I don't have any super full coverage foundations like the Huda Beauty Full Filter Foundation, but I do have another foundation that's medium but claims to be buildable, so I've never tried building it up, but we can try it. So like I said, I went to the States over the weekend, so I took the opportunity to go to the nearest Ulta Beauty store and try to check out the different products that they have that they don't sell in Canada, or that if I were to try to get them shipped to me, it would cost a horrendous amount of money for shipping, like Morphe. But unfortunately, while I did go to Ulta primarily to check out their Morphe products, because I was thinking of buying some brushes from them and some palettes from them as well, like the Jaclyn Hill palette I've been keeping my eye on. Unfortunately, that specific Ulta that I went to did not carry any Morphe, so I'm a bit sad. But I did still pick up some stuff anyways. So the look that I'm going to be doing today is this kind of purple monochrome cut crease look. It's going to be full coverage, glam, very bold. Going to do purple eyes, purple lips, going to be the whole package. So that is what I'm going to do. If you can tell, the backdrop still hasn't been ironed out yet. That's because I've been super lazy. But it will be fixed, don't worry. Sometime. It'll be fixed. Sometime. okay, so I'm pretty excited to show the new things that I got. And for the most part, I'll be using them in this video to complete this look, because they're more kind of intended for bolder looks. So let's start off with the first thing, okay? I'm going to tie my hair up first and then we will get right into it. Okay, so I'm gonna start off by quickly priming my eyelids, you know the thing, the drill. Usual. Okay, so now I'm gonna be using the Makeup Revolution Mermaids Forever eyeshadow palette. I picked this up at Ulta. And they have some really nice colors. A lot of like more bolder colors. They are surprisingly 90% shimmers, which I didn't realize when I was looking at the actual, like, the tester palette. But you know what? I think that we can make it work. And yeah, if you notice, it's a little bit, like, dirty here. Like, there's, like, can you see that? There's, like, these green things. I hope they're not boogers. But anyways, okay, so I'm gonna be starting off with a brush that's supposed to be here. Where did that go?
1 eternity later.
I'm gonna start off with this light pink shade as my transition. Just gonna kind of load that and place that on. I didn't swatch any of these beforehand, so I don't know how pigmented they are, but I'm hoping there's something. Okay, I mean, there's something. I mean, it's kind of showing up. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but you really have to swirl your brush into the pan in order for at least a little bit of pigment to show up on the brush and on your face. I mean, I guess it's fine. I think. I hope. So for my crease, I'm going to deepen it out a bit using this matte purple shade. And I say matte, but it does have a little bit of shimmer in it, so we'll see. I guess this is more like a first impressions kind of video. I'm just gonna pop that in my crease. That's not really showing up, but maybe if I keep at it. But I guess, kind of, but I don't know if that's just a pseudo effect. If, I mean, it seems like it's kind of coming out. But yeah, now I'm starting to see that pigment come off, but you really have to, like, work it into your crease and continuously go back, like dip back and forth into the pan, which is not ideal. It just sucks because these colors are so nice. Okay, I think I'm okay with that for now. Okay, so now I'm going to cut the crease. I'm not going to do the outer corner just yet because I'm going to be using a black color for that. And I don't really want to, I just want to leave that for now. So I'm going to be cutting the crease. I have never done a cut crease before. Kind of cut crease, like just in the middle, like just in the center in a previous video, but I mean, I wouldn't really consider that a proper cut crease. So yeah, this is technically my first time. I'm a baby. So I'm just gonna use a little concealer brush and I guess I'll just cut the crease. I mean, let's just pray here, guys. Does that look okay? That looks horrendous to me. There's that one tiny one that went a little bit too far. I'm not happy with that, but I think I can fix it later. Oh my god, I butchered that one. Okay, I think that's okay. Is that okay? I don't want to like move my eyes from this position. I think I said it now. You might tell that I'm doing this pretty much blind. So I'm gonna set it, I guess, with like this white powder. Okay, I guess now we'll just continue. I might kind of just like quickly kind of go around these edges here because it's making me sad. Okay, I just want to blend away that little spot. It's a little better. I mean, is that even okay? I don't know, this looks so strange. I'm gonna take now the that same crease brush because it's pretty small, and I'm gonna go into the Sephora Mixology palette. It has a nice black matte black shade that the Makeup Revolution palette doesn't have. Like, it has a black shade, but it's super shimmery, and I'm not about that life. So I'm just gonna use the black shade there, and I'm just gonna pop that in my outer corner. I think that's okay for now. I might try to darken it up a little bit afterwards, but we'll see. Okay, so now that that's done and over with, I'm going to take this little brush right here, and I'm going to use this like pinky super light purple color right here, and I'm going to use that on the lid. Blue. Okay, I'm gonna use my finger instead, just real quick. This doesn't look that great. Okay, I'm gonna use something else. A little bit more noticeable. I'm going to go into the Urban Decay Moondust palette. I'm gonna use the color here, Magnetic. It's pretty purple, so I'm gonna use that. My finger. Yeah, that's a lot better. Wow, that is purple. I love those little blue flecks in it. Oh, so gorgeous. Okay, so I'm just gonna quickly, I kind of want to darken out the further into the crease a little bit more, so I'm gonna take that purple shade and just kind of run it around here. Okay, I'm just gonna quickly take a little bit more of that black shade, just a teensy bit. So really darken out that crease. Looks gorgeous. Okay, I'm gonna take just a teensy bit more of that black shade and darken out the outer corner a bit more. I'm gonna do my brows now. No, I'm not. I'm gonna continue with my eyes. I always forget to do that. It's like I do the eyeshadow and I'm done. That's it. Nothing else. Okay, I'm gonna do my eyeliner. I picked up the NYX Epic Ink Liner. The thing that really sucks about this eye in particular is that there's a giant fold right here. I don't know if you can tell, it's like that cuts right into where you would normally do your ring. So whenever my eyes are kind of relaxed, it makes the wing look super wonky and thick and not even, when in reality it actually looks nice, but then it looks like that. Now the trick is making this eye look even. I'm going to, do my usual tight lining. Put that a little bit in my waterline. And then I'm going to use the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes Mascara. I picked this up in Ulta as well. I'm not gonna do my bottom lashes just yet. Okay, so I'm just gonna quickly do my brows off camera, and then I will be back. Alright, so I did my eyebrows just a little bit bolder. I set them with, I did set them with the Maybelline Tattoo Studio Brow Gel, and I also used the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow to kind of give them a little bit more structure and boldness. So now I'm going to quickly do my face. I'm gonna do my normal color correcting. And then I'm going to use a more fuller coverage foundation than you've seen me wear on this channel. I'm gonna go like this for Halloween. I'm gonna be the purple glam fatty that ate too much lasagna. Now foundation. So the foundation that I'm gonna be using is actually the first foundation that I've ever used. It's the Sephora 10-Hour Wear Perfection Foundation. It's meant to be medium coverage and buildable. And it says that it is oil-free. Let's try it out. I'm gonna use a brush. So that's, wow, definitely a lot more full coverage than I'm used to. But you know what? It's not that bad. Okay, so I'm gonna quickly conceal. And I'm gonna set that with a brush. Okay, so I'm just gonna quickly do my under eye area now. I'm gonna take a small brush and just go in with that lighter purple shade, and I'm gonna take that under my lower lash. I'm gonna try again that same pink shade that I used initially for the cut crease, and I'm gonna put that in the corner. I'm gonna quickly bronze up my face. So for this channel, I was thinking of doing a series where it would kind of be like a monochrome series. So basically I would just be doing monochrome looks where I try to just use one color on the lips and the eyes. And if I come across something, then also maybe like a colored highlighter or something like that, which I think would be pretty cool. I would do like a look with just blue colors, just green colors, pink, red, all of that stuff. So keep an eye out for those kind of videos. Now I'm gonna quickly do some contouring. I'm gonna use the this liquid highlighter. It's I picked it up. It's the Makeup Revolution liquid highlighter in rose gold. I'm blending that out with the Beauty Blender. I really like it, I just feel like it's not blending properly. It might be because I forgot to do it first before I put on the powders. It's most likely why. It's not cooperating with me. I don't know how it's translating on camera. It might look better on camera or worse, but in person it looks very strange. It looks like it's not properly blended, and no matter how I try to blend it, it will not blend. So, maybe if I layer it with the powder highlighter, it'll kind of like cover that up. So, I'm gonna use the Tarte Amazonian Clay Highlighter in Exposed. And yes, I am going for that blinding highlight on all sides of the face. I feel very highlighted right now. Oh, I forgot to do my bottom lashes, so I'm just gonna quickly do that. Now, for the fun part, I bought some new lashes, and guess what? They're Lily lashes. So I bought them in the style Mykonos because I've seen them on a couple other YouTubers and they look absolutely gorgeous. So yeah, I had to pick one up. I'm going to take these out of the box, which is actually really nice. Like, it's a really nice case. So I'm gonna take them out and trim them, and I will be back with them on. I like these lashes a lot. Oh, I feel so glam, which, you know, is the point of this video, but I feel very cute. They look so nice. Oh my gosh. Wow. Now these lashes, I might incorporate a little more into my looks. I think that's about it for the rest of the face. All that's left now are the lips. So what I'm going to be using is this lipstick by Bobbi Brown. It's their Luxe lip color in the shade Brocade. And I love this lipstick. It's a very nice, like, pretty purple, very vibrant purple color. And I think it will turn out pretty interesting on this look, so why not? like I said, very vibrant color, but it's really nice. It does easily transfer when you first put it on. It's very creamy, but once it dries down, it takes a while to dry down, but once it does, it's fine. It's a lot more violet-y, magenta-y kind of than a proper purple like the eyes, but I'm not mad at it. So yeah, I think that is it. So yeah, this is the final look. I think it turned out really nice. I am pretty happy with the way that this turned out. I really love these lashes. I love the sparkle. And you know what? I think that cut crease did not turn out as bad as I expected. Although I feel like, I don't know, I've seen cut creases like that you can tell they're cut creases, and I can't really, like, I feel like it just kind of blends seamlessly, so it's not, I guess, not really proper cut crease, but you know, this was my first time, so practice makes perfect. I'll probably do some more cut creases in future videos, but other than that, I really like the way that this look came out. I feel very highlighted, very glam, very fabulous, but I'm happy with it. So yeah, I really enjoyed participating in this campaign thing that Cult Beauty is doing. If you wanted to participate in it as well, don't forget to include the hashtag MakeMe in your Instagram post. So that way they can see it, and you will be, I believe if they select you, you'll be given £100 or whatever is equivalent to your currency, I'm assuming, to shop at Cult Beauty. Yeah, I hope you like this look. If you like the video, don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe to my channel, click the notification bell. Check out my Twitter and Instagram. Follow my Twitter if you want to be updated on whatever I'm doing during the week, and I'll also post there if I for some reason can't post a video on a certain day or during the week, or if I will be posting but later on or whatever. Follow me on Instagram so that I can see what kind of looks you make using the MakeMe hashtag as well. You can at me, and I'll be sure to check them out. Let me know what you think about that monochrome series idea. I really want to do it, so I'll probably do it anyways, but let me know if you would be interested in seeing it as well. That is it. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.